really good safety program is going to be written and communicated to employees on a regular basis. It shouldn't be just a document that sits on a shelf somewhere. It needs to be something that's living. We make edits to it. We make improvements to it all the time. You can call safety programs whatever you want. You can call them safety plans. You can have safety rules or safety expectations in personnel files or personnel programs. You can call it whatever you want, but it's a list of expectations that an employer would put together to help reduce injury risk, incident risk, and keep employee awareness high. It needs to be communicated to employees through safety meetings or employee meetings of some sort where we actually sit down and review the document. We encourage employers to have no unwritten safety rules. They all need to be written down. What do you expect? Two additional key elements to any successful safety program is monitoring. So if you say you want hard hats, if you say you want seat belts, if you say you want eye protection, you need to go out there and make sure people are actually doing that. And if they're not, the last most important thing is what we would call corrective action or enforcement. If there's a safety issue and you fix it, document that. If you have an employee that maybe needed some coaching to wear PPE correctly or wear their seatbelt, document that. So it's have the written program, talk with employees about it on a regular basis through safety meetings, monitor what employees are doing, and do corrective action if something isn't right. And you know, another thing that we need to think about too is thanking employees. If you have an employee that's actually wearing their gear, wearing their seatbelt, doing the right thing, then maybe as a part of the safety program, let's thank them for that. Little incentives like that really go a long way. No employer, no business, no organization can afford an incident. Yes, we do have insurance coverage for a lot of things, but we know that when employees are hurt, that's skills that aren't at work, we have equipment that's down, we're not getting things done, nobody can afford an incident. Also, another thing we have to think about too is there is no such thing as a small employer when it comes to safety. If you're a 3-person organization, if you're a 5-person organization or 10 people, or you're a 3,000 employee organization, nobody can afford an incident. So we want appropriately sized, appropriate safety programs for all employers, not only small employers, but large ones as well. So we know that all employers need safety programs. So what the agent would really want to do is look at that customer and really ask, what do they do? Ask, do they have a safety plan in place? Refer them to Missouri Employers Mutual. We can help with on-site consultation. We can help with consultation over the phone. We can provide resources. We also need to understand that many employers can't afford financially to have these incidents. So a safety plan in place really helps address things like experience ratings that could go up, claims costs that could go up, an incident that could occur, let's say while we're driving or we have a fall incident. So we really want to get into the prevention mode. And a good way to prevent these incidents is to have a safety plan that's discussed with employees and that management is enforcing.